Ready.
All right, well, I brought it out to a hair over 5 inches, and it's mostly at a quarter of an inch. I don't have a flatter, so I'll be using this hammer, setting it on top of the steel. It's got two nice flat faces. And hammering it from the other side. Yes, I know that there's potential for steel to break off. There's always that potential. Flatters, new, cost over $100 in a lot of places. So I'm still pricing them, still looking around. But anyway, I'll take one more heat to flatten this out really well. And then this end down here where my tongs are will be my my tang. I'm probably going to cut off probably a quarter inch or so because that's where everything was welded together. You'll have unsightly additives and things there from a mechanical welder. And the other end out here is where my blade is going to be. So we're going to take the flatter to it, take one or two more heats, get the flatter to it, and then start drawing out a tang, see what we're going to end up with there. I don't know. What do you think? Maybe a short double-edged boot knife or just a little single-edged, little utility type knife? I don't know. We'll see what I'm going to do with it next. Alright, so that off. Flat on the anvil, drop the tongs, and away we go, I hope. Back over there. Spin around. Sometimes you talk to your work. People start thinking you're crazy too.
Is it a little difficult?
Miss work alone these days. I don't know. All right, so now we're going to heat the other end and do the same thing. Yeah, that's what we're going to do.
Go.
All right, what I'm going to do on this operation is try to create a fullered area. My mark burned off. Try to create a fullered area here for my tang. Exactly where I wanted it, but we'll work on that. If I need more, I'll get more. And I'll tell you what, we'll back it up here. Should just fuller it on out and start my process, I guess. But I'm losing my heat. Now again, working on the end of the anvil. May or may not cut that off, depending. Considering this looks like it's going to be a hidden tang knife. I may not cut this end off like I was talking about because it won't be seen. But now it's time to heat up and start forging out my tang. If I get my camera lady to turn the blower on, I'd be happy. Actually, I don't have it.
Okay, I got it.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I like to keep things a little bit lighthearted because there's so much in the world to be upset about. And in our own lives, we face battles every day, struggles, and they aren't really worth going into in a forging video. But I do like to keep things a little bit lighthearted around my forge, you know, because, yeah, sometimes forge gets stressful too, and it's not a lot of fun. But I've learned that when it starts getting to where things aren't going right, shut the thing down, go in the house. If I move from one thing to another and it's still not going right, it's time to just shut the forge off, shut down any tools that are running, whatever, put it away and go in the house. Because it just is not your day.
Hey, Mom.
Ooh, nice welding heat again.
Yeah.
Look out.
Mom.
Fattened it up a good bit, but I need to draw it back out and thin it out some. Oh yeah, I'm gonna have far more than I thought I had here. Remember what I said about quick feet? I can't dance, but I can move my feet. right, well, it looks like I'm going to have to come in on the other side and work it down where it's a little more even and bring that out. Let's see how long it is at the moment, that tang that is.
Just a minute.
Right around 2 3/4. I'd like to bring it out to at least about 4 if I can. That would make a good hidden thing. Anyway, back to the fire we go.
And where I go.
Supposed to tell you. I was supposed to tell my camera lady that we'd be recording this heat. And I forgot to. I like the shape of that tang, but all right, let's straighten it a little. So there's what we've ended up with for the tang. I think I'll grind it the rest of the way to shape, and we've got, I don't know if you see that on the camera, we got nearly 4 inches.
Sort of.
Here, let me see. See what I can see here. Wow, they got hot. Got about 3 3/4 inches of tang there. I think I'm going to end up making this a hidden tang blade. Yeah, we're going to make, well, you know what? I'll draw it out just a little more, but it's going to end up being a hidden tang blade. And after the next video, after drawing out, I'm going to start on the edge. So it's time to decide what this is going to be. Probably past time to decide what it's going to be. But here we go. We'll start with the last one. All right, well, I've already hammered a little bit of distal taper into the blade. I'm learning more and more about doing that. I've got a big blade right now that I showed in my introduction video that I'm having to grind it into. But I've hammered it into this one somewhat. And I've decided to go with a little double-edged dagger. Let's see what we come up with here. Kind of chamfer those ends there a little bit. So maybe I can bring it down to a point without so much of a bird, what they call a fish mouth on the end that I got to grind off.
It was going.
So I've started working in the point a little bit. I'm just going to take it slow because, like I say, I end up with a lot of smiths, especially new guys, end up with a pucker right in there that's a flaw in the blade. I've had to grind them out and grind them out and grind them out. So I'm actually trying to avoid that a little bit in this one by bringing it down, rounding off the edges, and just letting it come in nice and gently instead of puckering over and creating a crack. Well, not really a crack, but it is a crack because it's a flaw in the blade that has to come out. And you end up losing more material than you want to. So I'm going to work on that within the next. All right, well, I've hammered out the tang. I brought it down to a point. Things were a little bit cockeyed, and so I hammered some of that out, and there's still going to be some that I'm going to have to correct. But as I kind of thought I would, I ended up hammering out some of the distal taper that I put in it. Because as you hammer it down this way, it's going to fatten everything up. But there's still some in there. But my next step is going to be to start on the edge bevels. So that's going to be where I go now. It's funny, you can still see, which I've always seen it in other people's work too, but you can still see the layers in this piece. You still feel the heat. It's still probably around 1,000 degrees. So this is actually the most dangerous heat in your forge because, okay, that piece doesn't look hot. Somebody grabs it, and they find out very quickly that it's plenty to scorch them. So we're going to go back to the forge now and start working on edge bevels. Like I said, I need to clean off my forge.
Where I go?
All right. About to start hammering in the edge bevels. I really don't want to hammer too far on this, I don't think. I want to hammer them in some, but I want to be able to grind through the different laminations also. You see that's taking a wild turn there, and that's to be expected. But as I come back and hammer the other side, it's going to straighten that out. A lot of people go into counting the edges or counting the number of strikes per side and everything else. I've never had a lot of success with that. Blade still warps in heat treat or annealing, heat treating, tempering. So I can find other ways to get around that instead of having it warp.
Sorry, I would have got that. Where'd it go?
All right, coming on to the other edge. Right now I've got a nice one side, single edge knife, the way it's shaped at the moment. Alright, well, looks a little rough at the moment. I've done this edge and this edge, both of them on this side of the blade. Now I'll move to the other side of the anvil in the next heat and work opposite. The next two heats, work opposite edges. Yeah, that's what we'll do. I also have a problem in the forge. I work alone at my day job, so I have to do what gets done. If anything needs to be picked up, I don't care if I've got to walk all the way across my shop, I got to do it. So I'm not used to having someone in the forge to help me out, and my camera girl, my daughter, would be glad to turn the blower on and off for me if I just remember to ask her. So you see me get right up close to the camera and turn it on or off, and I'm sure that makes for a rough sight, but so anyway, I'm going to try to remember to have her turn it off, and she'll go ahead and do that for me. Thank you.
You're welcome. It's snowing again.
A real strangely shaped knife again at the moment. Kind of funny, but we'll fix that one way or another.
I think it looks good.
Could do an elvish load. Nah. Fired up.
There we go.
Might add this one to my Ranger kit when I'm done with it. It's kind of in the process of being rebuilt. I'm a member and actually a moderator on Middle Earth Ranger Forum, reenacting the Rangers such as Aragorn. We don't have any Aragorns on the site. Nobody claims that name. But so that has kind of, over the last several years with tough times that we've fallen on, has kind of fallen by the wayside, and I need to rebuild that kit. But check it out at ranger.budgetauthenticity.org. It's a nice little forum. I haven't been as active on there as I should be, but lots of good information if you're interested in wilderness camping, wilderness survival, primitive camping. It's not modern. It's a really good site.
What was that site again?
That was ranger.budgetauthenticity.org.
Okay.
/forum. Forum or forums? I can't remember exactly. Trying to be cattywampus on me again.
Set
fire to it.
You want me to put that out?
No, I got it.
Okay.
Got stinks in here.
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay, well, I didn't, and I have a one thing I need to learn is to make a nice center ridge with my forging. I'm going to end up having to grind the center ridge in it. A little bit twisted at the moment.
Yep, just
so
a little
go,
bit.
I'm going to go through one more heat and see if I can straighten that twist out. And we will be done with the forging from there. There's also a little bit of unevenness here.
I'm getting the sun in it. There we go.
So yeah, there's a little unevenness right in here. A little bit different from the top. So let's see what we can knock out real quick. See if we can make that better.
You want me to turn it on?
So we've got a kink and we've got... if I fix the kink, it might fix that. Anyway, okay. Yes, turn it on. Could have put a little fuller in it, I suppose, but for one, I need to heat treat my fuller, the spring part of it, and two, I think it's just going to be good with a nice center ridge, a blade this small. As a matter of fact, with the layers in it, I'd probably want to grind in the fuller instead of hammering it in. What are we going to do?
Uh-oh. And in the way.
All right, so I'm going to take one last heat. If you look right in here, the tang is a little bit bent. So I'm going to take one more heat and see if I can just flatten everything out. And then we will be done with forging for a while. I'll probably go ahead and normalize it a couple times and be ready to call it quits for the forging.
Turn it on.
Fire it up.
Okay.
I ate my last Hershey's Kiss. It's time to quit.
Let me see if we have any more.
No, I'm fine.
Okay.
I don't need it, especially with lunch on the way.
I thought I heard her close, open the door, but not enough.
A lot of times on my knives, I have a general idea what I'm going to do. I don't do the greatest on drawing it out, and even when I do draw it out, I don't exactly follow what I drew out. So I kind of end up winging it. You know, just going along and what develops. Guys that order knives from me normally understand that. It's sort of an unspoken thing between us and me and them, I think. Them and me. I get more and more where I appreciate the work that I do. It comes out attractive. People like it. So I'm just going to keep doing what I do. I used to never produce a blade that I liked, but everybody else loved it. My first double-edged blade has about a 2.5 inch blade. And to me, it looks like a flame between the guard and the handle and the blade itself. It looks like a... Go ahead and turn it off, if you will.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It looks like an ice cream cone with a fire sitting on top of it to me. But I made it for a guy who is also on the Ranger form that I mentioned a while ago. Made it probably 4 years ago. He loves it. If he loves it, I love it. I didn't like it when it left my hands, but he loves it, so you know what? I love it too. But now I've finally gotten to the point with my blades that I can look at it and say, hey, that's pretty good. I can do better next time. And I hope to always stay at that point with my blades. Yeah, that's good. We can do better next time. So now I'm going to go through a couple of heats here to get it to where it's these magnets on the side of my forge. You see, it won't stick to the magnets now.